You are singing very well.
Okay.
Okay, you can.
Yes. Thank you. I am Zehra Özdemir. I am associate professor in Amada University, and I talk about the speed of light and the electromagnetic curves in the optical fiber in semi-Riemannian space. First of all, I want to describe the electromagnetic wave. In here, we can see an electromagnetic wave model. In here, E is the electric field, and it is also called as polarization vector. And B is a magnetic field, and it is divergence-free vector field. And the plane spanned by the E and B called as polarization plane. And in here, the Z-axis can be assumed as an optical fiber. And in here, we can see that the tangent vector of the optical fiber perpendicular to the polarization plane. And thus, if we want to see a linearly polarized light wave along an optical fiber, the polarization plane make a rotation motion. During this rotation motion, the tip points of the electric field trace a curve called as Ritov curve. In here, the red one is Ritov curve, and this law called as Ritov's law. And the transportation of the polarization vector E along an optical fiber was initially investigated by Ritov. Then the extensions of the Ritov's law was given by Vladimirsky. The author showed that the polarization vector E and magnetic field B perform rotations with respect to Frenet frame T, N, and B along a light ray. The first geometric fuzz was introduced by Pankrahan. Then Berry observed some characterizations of a dynamical fuzz and the geometric fuzz shift. Berry's fuzz possesses remarkable geometric property, and it depends only on the geometric structure of the space and does not depend on the duration of the evolution. And the linearly polarized light wave is coupled into an optical fiber. It can perform rotations of a polarization during propagation. Rosen-Kugler examined this geometric rotation in the optical fiber and present various characterizations. Then this motion is observed by many authors in some areas. In here, we investigate that the polarization plane make a constant angle with the tangent vector of an optical fiber. If the polarization plane and the tangent vector of the optical fiber make a constant angle, then if you want to see a linearly polarized light wave, then the polarization plane make a homothetic motion. And if we make a homothetic motion, and for model of this form of motion, we obtain the split quaternionic forms of this motion and use the split quaternion. And now I want to introduce some information about the quaternion. The real quaternions was discovered by Hamilton, and then split quaternions were defined by Kuckel. And the fundamental role of the quaternion algebra is that easily describes the rotations in three-dimensional space. In Euclidean space, the spatial rotations can be expressed via the real quaternion. Similarly, in Lorentzian tree space, the spatial rotations can be expressed via the split quaternions. Moreover, quaternions are used in computer graphics, robotic systems, video games, computer programs, navigation systems, and various physical laws are also easily described due to quaternions. And in here, we use the inner product is given equation one. And since the Lorentzian metric has a minus, then we have three types of vectors, space-like, time-like, and null. And the Frenet frame equations related to the in Lorentzian Minkowski space defined by the equation 2. And the semi-Riemannian curvature tensor on M is given by equation 3. And then the sectional curvature of M is defined by the equation 4. And if the surface M has constant sectional curvature, then it is called semi-Riemannian space form. Then the curvature tensor of a semi-Riemannian space form is given as equation 5. And in here, we investigate the behavior of the charge particle in an electromagnetic field using the Killing magnetic vector field. And Killing magnetic vector fields, we know that the Killing vector fields are the lead derivative of the Killing vector fields are zero. Then this gives in three-dimensional space, the Killing vectors are divergence-free vector fields, and they define a special class of magnetic vector fields called as Killing magnetic vector fields, and the related Killing equations given by the equation 6. And the split quaternions, a split quaternion given by equation 7, and the set of the split quaternions given by the equation 8. And the split quaternion product given by the equation 9 and 10, and the metrical form of the split quaternion product given by the equation 11, and the conjugate norm and the inverse of a split quaternion given by the equation 12, 13, and 14. And since the vectors in semi-Riemannian manifolds have a casual character, the polar form a unit split quaternion defined by the following three cases. And the rotation matrix associated with a unit split quaternion given by the equation 16. And the homothetic motion given by the equation 17 and matrix representations of the homothetic motion given by the equation 18. In here, the eta is homothetic scalar. R is rotation matrix and T is translation vector. And again, since the casual characters of the vectors in Minkowski space, the angle between the two vectors in semi-Riemannian 3 manifolds have following characterizations A, B, and C. And so in the spherical coordinates, and using the casual characters of the vectors in semi-Riemannian manifolds, the electric field can be defined by the following four cases. And now we investigate the polarization states during the homothetic motion. The geometric path can be described by a space curve prism. And in here, we assume that the polarization plane make a constant angle with the tangent vector of the optical fiber. Then we can define that, we can assume that in here, E and the tangent vector T are time-like vectors in the same time-like cone. And then the angle between these vectors defined by the equation 19. And using the some operations, we and the spherical coordinates of the electric field, we obtain the geometric phase model of the electric field in equation 20. In here, we want to see a linearly polarized light wave and the homothetic motion of the polarization vector in a single mode fiber. Then we must take the angle beta is equal to integrations of tau. And then we can see that the rotational part of a homothetic motion make with the angle tau. And in here, we can say that the relation between parallel transportation and Fermi-Vorkos transportations gives equation 22. And this gives that during the homothetic motion of the polarization plane, the electric field moves with the Fermi-Walker parallel transportation rule, and thus by means of the Fermi-Walker parallelism, we may say that this form of optical fiber describes a curve as E1 Ritov curve. Namely, we obtain that the polarizing vector varies in the direction of the vector field E1. Then the polarization vector related to the fiber can be expressed as in equation 24. And then we can give some theorems related to the geometric path equations. Let us consider that linearly polarized light is coupled into an optical fiber related to the curve PC with the Frenet frame fields TN and B, and the angle between the tangent vector T and the polarized vector E be constant such that E and T are time-like vectors in the same time cone. And then the polarized light may perform a homothetic motion of polarization during propagation. So the unit split quaternion sigma, the parametric representations of the E1 Ritov curve is obtained as follows. So the split quaternion product, we obtain the equations 25. And so the homothetic motion, we obtain the parametric form of the E1 Ritov curve in equation 26. In here, the angle beta is equal to minus integrations of tau. And we can give a corollary. During the homothetic motion of the motion of the polarization plane, in here, since the tangent vector and the electric field is a time-like vector, then they are not perpendicular vectors. And if the other cases, if the angle between the homothetic between the polarization plane and the tangent vector of the optical fiber is a perpendicular angle, then the plane makes a rotation motion. And then during the homothetic motion of the polarization plane, the electric field trace a curve on the Lorentzian sphere, and this curve is given by the following, by the quaternion product and the homothetic motion, towards the homothetic motion, the parametric equations of this spherical curve given by the equation 27 and 28. And using similar cases, we obtain that if T if E spacelike and T time-like vectors, and E and T are space-like and B time-like vectors, E and T are space-like vectors, and N is time-like vector. We obtain similar characterizations, and similar calculations above, we obtain the geometric phase model related to the E, the polarization plane make a constant angle with the vector N, and the polarization plane make a constant angle with the B-normal vector B. And now using the geometric phase model, we can characterize the electromagnetic curve. The electromagnetic curve described by a curve, if a charged particle moves in an electromagnetic field, then the tangent vector of this particle is affected to the magnetic field. Then it is obtained a force called as Lorentz force. And with the influence of this Lorentz force, the particle moves in a new trajectory. This new trajectory called as electromagnetic trajectory and satisfies the equation 29. And using the obtained electromagnetic, if we consider all of the geometric phase models, we obtain the equation 30. And using the geometric phase model, we obtain that the Lorentz force equations related to the Frenet frame satisfy the equation 31, 32, and 33. And then using the Killing equations and the geometric phase model and the electromagnetic curve equations, we obtain that PC is a E1 electromagnetic curve if and only if Killing magnetic field B has the form in 34. And PC is a E2 electromagnetic curve if and only if Killing magnetic field B has the form in 35. And PC is a E three electromagnetic field, if and only if unique magnetic field B has the form in equation 36. And similar characterizations can be given for the E perpendicular N and E perpendicular B. And then we obtain this theorem. Let us consider that B is a Killing vector field in three-dimensional semi-Riemannian space form. Then curvature and torsion of E1 electromagnetic field satisfy the following differential equation. And if B is a Killing magnetic vector field and the E2 electromagnetic curve in the optical fiber are satisfied the following equations. And if B is a Killing vector field in three-dimensional semi-Riemannian space form, then the E3 electromagnetic curve in the optical fiber are halogens with constant curvature and constant torsion. Now I can give an example. In here, we give a parametric representations of curve QC in equation 30, and the related geometric state of this curve given by following three cases. In here, the shape of the homothetic motion of the electric field given by two types. In the first figure, in here we see that the blue curve are is optical fiber, and the red vectors are electric field. And the electric field during the homothetic motion the electric field moves with Fermi-Vogel parallel transportation rule, and the tip points of the electric field trace a curve, this curve called as E1 Rietorff curve, and given by the figure 2. And the other example is the polarization plane. Perpendicular polarization plane make a constant tangent with the normal vector and the related E2 Rietorff curve. And the last one is polarization plane make a constant tangent with the binormal vector and the related Rietorff curve. And these one are the a charge point particle, a trajectory of a charge particle in the electromagnetic view during the homothetic motion of the polarization plane given by the three cases. And this is my reference. Thank you for your attention.